and welcome to Intermission. Tonight, a riddle. What do arts, entertainment, and horses have in common? Walt Pinsent, an artist, musician, and expert horseman all rolled into one. Last fall, we spent a couple of days with Pinsent and had a chance to observe him indulging in all three passions. It's not something you see every day in Newfoundland, but there is something absolutely right about this picture. A rare harmony. A rare bond between man and beast and the great outdoors. For this man, the ultimate blend of life's pleasures. Not Walt Pinsent's combined love for horses and the Newfoundland landscape lends inspiration to his third great passion. For years, W.S. Pinsent, the artist, has been capturing on canvas the great outdoors and those who inhabit it. From the smallest to the greatest, and always with a touch of nostalgia.
Disappearing lifestyle is one area that I have done a lot of work in the past, like the disappearing stages and the farmlands and the older things that will disappear and are disappearing quickly. And in Newfoundland, we're still very fortunate to have some of the older lifestyles, and some our culture lends itself to hanging on to some of those things, right?
And some of those old ways are well worth hanging on to, like man's earliest form of transportation, the horse. Pinsent's fascination with the animal goes back a quarter of a century to when he joined the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Then it was required training. Now it's a full-fledged love affair. When Pinsent retired from the RCMP, he settled in Eastport and bought his own horse. When John Gardner decided to expand the horse rides at his amusement park near Glovertown to an overnight camping trip, Pinsent was a natural choice for trail boss.
One, two, three, go.
That means preparing both horses and riders for the two-hour journey to camp. Both the veterans...
That feels perfect.
Okay.
...and the novices.
One, two, three. Steer the horse.
And even the occasional nervous Nelly of a news reporter.
When you want him to go forward, all you have to do is let the rein drop slightly and tap your horse on the side, just slightly on the side, or pressure on the legs, and he should move ahead.
Why is he moving now?
The horses aren't wanting to move out, so...
Eventually, everyone's ready, and the trail ride begins.
Now, loose on the rein, just tap your... horse up there on the belly a little, or pressure on the legs.
Horseback riding is not all that common in Newfoundland, but once bitten, most get hooked. For Pinsent, each time out is a joy rediscovered.
It's the quietness of rolling along, walking along with a horse, and you can get up close to wildlife, you know, moose and caribou on a horse. Horses is an excellent mode of transportation. We seem to have forgot about it in the last 100 years. It's sort of a historical tie with the past, you know, to ride a horse. It takes you back in time. It connects you with all your other generations behind you, you know?
So what do you think of Walt when you go through a place like this?
Well, the autumn, of course, is very, very inspiring for most artists because you get the changing colors and you get the maple trees. The hills, particularly today, have a mist about them that shows distance. And I guess if you're a painter, horseback riding has got to be one of the best ways to inspire.
That was a good ride in today, John.
Yeah, that was nice.
No incidents. Never saw a moose, though.
And this is one boss who doesn't delegate the work.
Right.
Horse and artistic inspiration are put to one side as he and Gardner double as chief cooks and bottle washers. And the saddle sore and hungry wait for their reward. When everyone else is served, Pinsent himself takes time to eat and reflect on the turns his life has taken.
It's ironic that all at my age now everything would come to a head, and all the little things that I like are I'm doing, you know, like riding, painting, and just enjoying the outdoors. And it did come. Yeah, it's a good way to earn a living.
And Pinson's creative talents aren't limited to canvas or cuisine. As the night draws to a close, he entertains the troops.
Why she took you?
I've always had a love for singing, right? I guess there's no better place to howl than around a campfire. If you're going to sing and play the guitar, you take a dozen Newfoundlanders up to the camp. Just about every second one of them can play the guitar or accordion or a mouth organ or something, you see, so you've got lots of entertainment. So I enjoy that too. That's part of the job, getting in there and sitting around and making people feel comfortable and setting the mood for the evening, you know.
A formula that works, according to the customers.
Entertainment is good, hospitality is good, and they make you really feel at home.
So I like the horseback riding and the music, and it's a good time up there.
And the scenery coming in is lovely.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's relaxing after all week.
But despite his talents, Pinsent is unfailingly modest.
I've always thought of myself as being average, right? And I never ever really thought that I was better than anybody else, but you do know that you can do things better than some people, but that doesn't make me feel any higher or any better than anybody else. I just try and do things best I can. If I'm lucky at it, I do it good, and if I'm not, I just forget it. The things I like and I do well, I pursue, and those things I can't do, I just forget it, you know? I just don't pursue those things.
No matter, it's enough to say he breaks the mold for either a rough-and-ready cowboy or an intense artist. Though Pinsent insists they're really a lot alike.
Maybe we're too far from cowboys to really appreciate what they do, but cowboys, some of the best artists in the world were cowboys. Like the John Wayne type of cowboy is still there, but John Wayne wouldn't quote poetry, but most cowboys today will enjoy singing and poetry and painting and that kind of thing, because they're with it every day. Yeah?
Add the trusted steed, and life just doesn't get any better. Kind of lends new meaning to the notion of retirement. Well, that's intermission for this week, but tune in next week for the first of a three-part series from Nashville, Tennessee. First up, Eddie Eastman. This two-time Juno winner went as far as he could in Canadian country.